Hi, my name is Rush from Cloud9, and this is my basic champion guide to Lee Sin. Lee Sin champion is overrated. He's not that strong champion. He seems strong just because players of Lee Sin have played this champion a lot. So it is not that good to start this champion now, but he has some good points that make people keep playing it. Snowballing and freedom in your path with Ward W is his good point, but he has weak point on early game, not like you think. His early game is overrated. There are a lot of junglers that have better level 3 or 4 than Lee Sin's, like Mundo, Kindred, Alice, Rek'Sai, Gragas, Nidalee in this meta. This is really a lot. They are stronger than Lee Sin. But Lee Sin looks strong just because you can choose a fight. And it means you can fight only when you want. It's really good point. It's not like Gragas or Alice. Even though they can win 1v1, they cannot finish Lee Sin. But when Lee Sin see a chance, he can finish any enemy. This is why people think Lee Sin is strong at early game. And I can agree at this point. Lee Sin is really good at destroying enemy with warriors or some AD items and after 6. So in short, his Lee Sin in solo queue, his early game is not that strong, but he can look at chances and sometimes punish enemy, and after 6, he's strong enough. As I told you, Lee Sin is not that strong at level 3 or 4. It's better for you to play safe in early game. It does not mean that you should just farm only. It's better for you to counter gank enemy, because Lee Sin is really good at catching enemies and chasing enemies with Q and W and E slow. So you should think about enemy jungler, what he is going to do, and try to play around that zone and try to seek counter jungle. It's kind of aggressive and it's kind of passive, and you can have good early gank with CC lane like TF, Irelia, or Thresh, or Alista with Flash. So in short, Lee Sin should not look for 1v1 enemy aggressively, but it does not mean that you have to be scared, because you can still counter gank him or pick him off sometimes if you see a chance. Also, you can make good early gank with CC lane, as Lee Sin has not enough damage to finish full health enemy laner. It's better to look for lanes that have decent CC or lanes that are doing aggressive trade. Aggressive trade lane can be made with some melee matchup like Jax, Irelia. And one good early gank on that kind of melee matchup lane can make you win the game. So sometimes you can make jungle path around that lane, like Prox on the red side. For example, Prox, Raptors, Red to make fastest gank on top lane with enough health. With this path, you can use your second smite on Red to keep your health, and it works on this kind of path works a lot in solo. And when you try to gank, some of new Lee Sin players want to start gank with Q, but it's really bad. It's better for you to start with W, and after you have some near distance, then you have better chance of your hitting your Q, and sometimes after W, you can do some auto and chasing them with Q. It's really good, so don't start gank with a Q unless it's 100% kill. Lee Sin is considered as bad team fighter. It does not mean that you have to 1v1 only or split push. You can have some decent skirmishes like 3v3 or 4v4 with your skill set to pick up or catch enemy. If team fights start, you can choose to peel for your carries with kicking enemy bruiser back or try to insect enemy's carries. But I think, personally, kicking enemy bruiser is more stable to do as Lee Sin, because it is really hard to kick enemy carries back if enemy is trying to kill you first, and it's really hard to do. And as bruisers are in front of enemy, if you are lucky or skilled, you can hit 4 or 5 of enemy that makes you win the team fight. And for runes, I use 4 armor penetration on red and 5 flat attack damage. Just because with some armor penetration, you can do true damage on jungle camp. Basically, jungle camp has 10 armor, and you can get 5 from runes, and you can get 5 from precision, and it can make you to do true damage on jungle camp, which is more worth than 4 more AD damage. And for yellow, it is more stable to use armor, flat armor than hearth. And for blue, I prefer to use flat CDR, just because CDR means sometimes you can use more Q once more or W once more. It means that you can have a chance of doing some more damage or escaping with W. I prefer to use it, but sometimes against double AP or triple AP comp, it's better to use flat MR. And for Quint, I use just flat attack damage because it's most effective runes. I prefer to use 1218s Lee Sin, and my build, I have some logic about my build on Mastery. Like, some people prefer to use Sorcery as Lee Sin over Fury, but I prefer to use Fury just because plus 4 attack speed means that you can have better chance of using your one more auto. It's more worth than 2% damage increase of spell damage. And next, double-edged sword over Fist, just because some people think that Fist is better as jungler just because they can have 60 more health after first clear. But I think with double-edged sword, you can do more damage on jungle camp. It means that you can clear fast, and it also means that you'd take one less damage from jungle too. So double-edged sword can help you to sustain like Fist on jungle. And I prefer to use Vampirism over natural talent because most of people think that natural talent have some problem, and Vampirism it seems better on 1v1 or sustain both, and it's more safer to use Vampirism. And next, Bounty Hunter and Oppressor. Personally, I think Bounty Hunter is fine, but it's kind of gamble. If you fail to get some kills, then you'd have 0% damage increase. So most of people and I use Oppressor to be more stable. But you can use Bounty Hunter if you are really confident at making only kills. Yeah. And for next, Cunnings. As jungler, Wanderer and Savagery. Some people use Wanderer as jungler just because they can gank faster. But I think with 5 more damage increase on jungle camp, it means that you can have faster jungle clear speed, and it can make you gank faster too. So I prefer to use Savagery over as jungler. And next, Runic Affinity. I think it's the best as jungler because not only some people think it's for only blue and red, but it can help you to get more time of jungle buffs of Krogs, Grump, Baron buff. So it's good. It's not only applied on blue or red, for every buffs. So it's good. And as Lee Sin, you don't have mana, so it's better to use Merciless and Bandit and Dangerous Game. Dangerous Game is way better. And Precision. Precision with double penetration, and as I told you before, with 5 armor penetration runes, you can have 10, and you can do 3 damage on jungle camp, and you can have more damage on champions too, so it's really good. And your E damage is earth, magic damage, not like your thing. The magic penetration can help you a bit. And as Lee Sin, it's better to use Thunderlord, and Thunderlord is really maybe the best keystone in this patch. As jungle Lee Sin, normally we max, actually most of people start with Q, right? At level 1 and level 2. Some people, really rare people, put E on level 2, but it's better to put W. Even though E has more faster jungle clear speed, W can help you keep your health more than E. So it's stable to put W on level 2, and level 3, you should have 3 skills, so put a point on E, and it's basically QWE order. And max Q first, for sure, and for second max, most of pro player max W as Lee Sin on second, but I prefer to max the E after 2.0 of W at level 8. Just because W can give you a shield only when you use on champion, but if I use Ward W combo sometimes, it gives me nothing. So I think after 2 or 3 points on W, it's better to max on second. It's my opinion, it depends on your playstyle. Like, if you try to kill for your carries as Lee Sin, then it's better to max W, but if you wanna kill, if you wanna chase someone, it's better to max E on second. Lee Sin starts with Machete for sure, but with 150 extra gold, you can buy refillable or 3 pots. In my personal opinion, refillable pot forces you to recall early. Sometimes it can hurt your early game, so I prefer to buy 3 pots. Next, you normally have 700 gold at first recall, and most of League players want to upgrade jungle item with this gold, but I prefer to buy 2 long surge that it can provide you better jungler speed and better jungle clear speed than tier 2 jungle item, and more damage on champions do when you gank. So I think it's better to buy 2 long surge as Lee Sin. After this, you should buy Tracker's Knife unless you build a side stone, which is not that efficient like Season 5. Next, you should finish your Warrior and buy Butch. And after this, there's 2 builds. You can build Lockhead or Deadman's Plate. These 2 items are most effective, like efficient item in this patch. So if enemy has a lot of AP champions and your team is not going to build Locket, it's better for you to build Locket, but in normal situation, you should buy the Advanced Plate, because this item gives you some utility with movement speed, slow down enemy, and more damage, so this item is really good. And after this, there is really situational, like you can build Wurmog, you can build Banshees, you can build Thornmail. Thanks for watching my guide. Make sure to check out the rest at lurkclass.com.